Good morning, and welcome to WWDC.
At WWDC 2021, Apple formally introduced iOS 15, coming to the iPhone this fall. Craig Federighi started off by talking about how Apple can help you stay connected in better ways. The first update is to FaceTime, and it's getting a major one. For example, audio capture is getting upgraded for a better audio experience.
Now your friends' voices are spread out to sound like they're coming from the direction in which they're positioned on the video call, making your calls more comfortable and more natural. Let's talk about two powerful new options for your microphone. The first is voice isolation. When you're on a FaceTime call, your mic is picking up a cacophony of sound. So in voice isolation, machine learning distinguishes these sounds, blocks out the ambient noise, and prioritizes your voice so that it comes through crystal clear. Sometimes, though, we want every bit of sound to come through. And that's when you switch to wide spectrum. In wide spectrum, your mic picks up an entire symphony's worth of sound, your voice and everything around you.
There are new ways to see people in your FaceTime call as well.
You can now turn on grid view, giving you another way to view your group FaceTime calls. Here you see people in the same size tiles, and you'll be able to clearly identify who's speaking while seeing everyone else's reactions. We're introducing portrait mode. In FaceTime, portrait mode blurs the background and naturally puts the focus on you.
You can now also generate links to schedule and share calls with others.
We've created FaceTime links. Now you can generate a link for a FaceTime call and share it anywhere. You can send the FaceTime link in places like messages, email, WhatsApp, or jump into Calendar and make an event for your FaceTime call so everyone will know exactly where to meet and when. And it's not just Apple devices that can use a FaceTime link to join your call. Your friends with Android and Windows devices can use your FaceTime link to join the call right from their browser.
And the last update to FaceTime is called SharePlay, allowing you to share content effortlessly.
Let me show you how this works, starting with listening together. Say you're hanging out on a FaceTime talking about a new album that came out over the weekend. With SharePlay, you can bring that album right into the conversation. When you're on a call, all you need to do is press play in Apple Music, and you can choose to listen together. And like magic, high-quality music playback will start in sync for everyone on the call. And you're still connected with FaceTime while listening. Everyone on the call can add songs to a shared queue, and shared playback controls let anyone press play, pause, or jump to the next track. When you're on a FaceTime call, jump to a streaming app and press play, and boom, you and your friends are watching the same video totally in sync. If the group wants to stay connected with no interruptions to the video sound, you can jump into messages and keep the conversation going there. And when the moment calls for a bigger screen, you can extend the video to your Apple TV and watch it there while sharing the moment with your friends over FaceTime on your iPhone. SharePlay is designed to work with your other favorite apps and streaming services. With an API built for easy adoption, developers can bring their own apps right into FaceTime. Finally, check out screen sharing. You can use it to browse Zillow listings live with your future roommates or show off a tricky move in your favorite game. Screen sharing is also a simple and super effective way to help someone out and answer questions right in the moment. And it works across Apple devices.
The second major update is to messages. Mindy took over to talk about the new design as it applies to photo sharing.
Look at this brand new collage design. In this cool stack with even more photos from Taylor, I can quickly swipe through them, tap to view the full bunch, and even add a quick tap back.
Then she dug into how sharing things in a conversation can apply to other applications.
Let me show you something we designed just for that, called Shared With You. So now, if I head over to the news app, there's a new Shared With You section that conveniently surfaces that pizza article and a few from my other friends. Now that I'm ready to learn more, I can take a look. And check this out. Up top, it shows me who it's from. And I can tap From Casey to pick up our conversation and remind her that deep dish is obviously the best kind of pizza. Well, over in the Photos app, the new Shared With You section makes it super easy to get back to them. They'll also appear in my featured photos and memories. And what's really cool is they're automatically brought over to my library too. So if I scroll back to that Joshua Tree trip and drill in, you can see all the great photos my cousin sent are right here with the ones I took. And Photos is smart enough to only bring over the ones I actually care about, like the ones I was there for. so I don't have to worry about screenshots or memes cluttering up my library.
In addition to Photos, Apple Music, and News, we've built Shared With You into Safari, Apple Podcasts, and the Apple TV app. And if something especially important comes through, you can quickly pin it, and it'll be elevated and shared with you and places like Search.
Craig came back to discuss the changes that help you focus throughout your day and stay in the moment. First off, notifications are getting a new look and are now easier to manage.
They have a fresh new look, contact photos for people, and larger icons for apps, making them even easier to identify. To help you engage on your own time, we're introducing the Notification Summary, a helpful collection of your notifications you can schedule to be delivered at any time you choose, like in the morning and evening. Notifications in the summary are ordered by priority, with the most relevant ones rising to the top. Notifications from people will not end up in the summary, so you won't miss important messages as they come in. It's even easier to step away and focus if people know we're busy. So we created an easy way to signal to others when you're doing that. Now, when you're using Do Not Disturb, your status is automatically displayed in messages. When you reach out to someone who's indicated they don't want to be disturbed, you'll be reminded in that moment. And for truly urgent messages, there's a way to get through.
In order to help draw boundaries, Apple introduced something called Focus, which contains profiles based off your activity.
Focus is a new way to match your device to your current mindset. With Focus, all you have to do is choose what you want to focus on. You can carve out time in your day for work or your personal life. When setting up a focus, we use on-device intelligence about your past activity to suggest apps and people to allow notifications from. So if you're at work, you could choose to only be notified by coworkers or apps like Mail, Calendar, or Slack. For your personal life, we'll suggest being notified only by friends and family or apps like Calm. And for a home screen to match, you can have your favorite entertainment apps like YouTube or widgets for keeping up with your friends and family. We'll even intelligently suggest using a focus based on your context, using different signals like location or time of day. And when you use a focus on one device, it automatically sets on all your other devices.
Next, Craig highlighted ways Apple will use intelligence in order to get better information from photos. First, there is Live Text, which spotlights text in a photo.
It starts with the camera. I can now just point the camera at the whiteboard, and an indicator appears here in the lower right. When I tap it, the text just jumps right out. I can use my normal text selection gestures, just drag and copy. Now I can switch over to Mail and paste those in, and then send this off to Tim. And this is great for photos already in your photo library. Here's a photo of a friend. You may notice that here at the top, there's some text. Now, I can just select it like this, and I have the option to use Lookup to find out more about this restaurant and even look up its location. Live Text works with photos across the entire system, including screenshots, Quick Look, and even photos on the web. And it understands 7 languages, including simplified and traditional Chinese, and works across iPhone, iPad, and Mac. You can also look up information on recognized objects and scenes. Just tap, and you can look up information like the breed of a dog or type of a flower. We're also making it easier to search for your photos by adding photos to Spotlight. Now, with Photo Search in Spotlight, you can quickly find your photos right from the home screen. Spotlight leverages intelligence from the Photos app so you can search by people, scenes, elements in your photos, or a location like San Francisco. And leveraging Live Text, Spotlight can even find text in your photos. We've also added all new rich results for contacts. You'll have quick access to call, text, FaceTime, or email them. And Spotlight intelligently includes everything related to them. Their location, if shared through Find My, recent conversations, shared photos, calendar appointments, notes, and files. And we've added all new rich results for actors, musicians, TV shows, and movies as well.
Then Chelsea took over to talk about how photo memories are going to be organized for unique creations.
Here in the Photos app, I can tap on the For You tab, and my memories are right at the top. Check out this beautiful new animated title card. Let's watch this one of my climbing adventures. You'll hear a relevant, personalized song from Apple Music that brings the memory to life. They're interactive and alive, and are paced to the beat of the music. I can touch and hold to pause, and the music continues to play. When I let go, the pacing adjusts to get back on beat. And to see a photo again, all it takes is a swipe. To customize my memory, I'll use a new feature called Memory Mixes. I can tap to bring up the controls, then tap this button to jump in. Swiping on this carousel lets me try out different mixes with intelligently chosen songs, pacing, and a look to match. Notice how the feel of the memory changed with a calmer song, slower transitions, and a black and white look. To check out more intelligent song suggestions, I'll tap on the music button. You'll notice these top suggestions are a great fit for my climbing memory. With tens of millions of songs in the Apple Music Library, experts have curated sets of songs that are combined with my music tastes and the knowledge of what's in my photos to create personalized recommendations just for me.
The last major component of iOS 15 revolves around exploring the world, and it starts with more options in the Wallet app, presented by Jennifer.
With iOS 15, we're bringing keys for your everyday places to Wallet. Starting with where you live, we're creating the fastest, most secure way to unlock your house, apartment, or flat. And where you work, just add your corporate badge and tap to enter your building or office. And where you travel, with hotel keys, you'll automatically receive your key when your room is ready, even before you arrive at the hotel. So we're bringing identity cards to Apple Wallet. This fall, you'll just scan your driver's license or state ID in participating U.S. states. It's that easy. Your ID information is now in Wallet, encrypted and safely stored in the secure element. And the TSA is working to enable airport security checkpoints as the first place you can use your digital ID. When you present your ID, you'll know what specific information is requested and securely presented. With just a tap, you're off to your flight.
Then Craig took us through the updates to the Weather app.
The Weather app is incredibly popular, and it's getting a huge update. First, we're introducing a beautiful new design with data and layouts that change based on conditions, such as wind and rain, unhealthy air quality, or sunny skies. We've also added new weather graphics to help users better understand conditions like wind, UV index, and barometric pressure. And we've completely redesigned the gorgeous animated backgrounds. There are now thousands of variations that more accurately represent the sun position, clouds, and precipitation.
And then Meg joined us to show off the new Apple Maps features coming to select cities.
But in iOS 15, Maps will offer incredible new details for commercial districts, marinas, buildings, and so much more. We've added things like elevation, new road colors and labels, as well as hundreds of custom design landmarks for places like Coit Tower and the Golden Gate Bridge. And we built a beautiful new nighttime mode with a moonlit glow. We've added a great deal of new road details to the map so we can help drivers as they move throughout a city to better see and understand important things like turn lanes, medians, bus and taxi lanes, and more. And when driving on highways, Maps now renders overlapping complex interchanges in three-dimensional space, making it much easier to see upcoming traffic conditions or to know which lane you need to be in. We've also made big improvements for transit riders by helping them easily find nearby stations. Users can pin their favorite lines to the top and even keep track on their Apple Watch, so there's no need to take your phone out of your pocket. Maps also automatically follows your transit route, notifying you it's time to disembark as you approach your final destination.
At WWDC, Apple also dug into privacy and what steps they are taking to protect users. Katie went over changes coming to the Mail app.
So now in the Mail app, we're introducing Mail Privacy Protection. Here's what it does. It hides your IP address, so senders can't link it to your other online activity or determine your location. And it prevents senders from seeing if and when you've opened their email.
Eric then talked about privacy updates to Safari.
And this year, we're making it even stronger by also hiding your IP address from trackers, so they can't use it to link your activity across different sites or learn your location. You can see which trackers are prevented from profiling you in the Safari Privacy Report.
So we're introducing the App Privacy Report. This new section in settings gives you an overview of how apps treat your privacy. You can see how often apps use the permission you've granted to access your location, photos, camera, microphone, contacts, and more during the last 7 days. And to find out who your data may be shared with, you can see all the third-party domains the app is contacting.
Siri is also getting on-device processing thanks to the neural engine.
We recently added more diverse Siri voice options, and they sound incredible.
Hi, I'm Siri. If you need anything, just ask.
Today, we're introducing on-device speech recognition. This means that by default, your audio is all processed right on your iPhone or iPad. This addresses the biggest privacy concern we hear for voice assistants, which is unwanted audio recording. And this has some great benefits beyond privacy. First, you can now make many requests without an internet connection, launch apps, change settings, control music, and more. Second, on-device processing speeds things up.
Mike took over to chat about iCloud with updates like account recovery and digital legacy. He also introduced a new subscription service called iCloud Plus.
First, we're adding a new way to get back into your account if you ever forget your password or get locked out. You'll now have the option to add people you trust, like family and friends, to a recovery contact list. They won't get any access to your account, but if you ever forget your password, you can call them to get the code you need to get right back in. Second, we're launching a new digital legacy program. We don't often think about it, but it's important that we can easily pass down information to family members or friends when we pass away. You'll now be able to add people to your account as legacy contacts. So when you're gone, they can simply request access and your information can be passed along quickly and easily. We're upgrading our paid subscription to something that we call iCloud Plus. iCloud Plus combines everything you love about iCloud with some great new features. We are introducing a new service called Private Relay. It lets you browse with Safari in an even more secure and private way. It ensures that the traffic leaving your device is encrypted, so no one can intercept and read it. Then all of your requests are sent through two separate internet relays. It's designed so that no one, including Apple, can see both who you are and what sites you're visiting. And it does all this without compromising performance. Next, let's talk about another iCloud Plus feature, Hide My Email. With Hide My Email, you can share a unique, random address that forwards messages to your personal inbox. And it's built right into Mail, Safari, and iCloud settings. So it's easy to set up as many addresses as you need and delete them at any time, keeping you in control. More and more of us are using security cameras to keep an eye on our homes. With iCloud Plus, you can connect more cameras than ever. And none of the video counts against your iCloud storage. It's just a part of your subscription. Of course, you'll still get everything else you love about iCloud, including photos, backup, and iCloud Drive. And the best part is, we're not changing our prices at all. You'll get all of iCloud, plus our new private relay service, Hide My Email, and expanded HomeKit secure video support.
The updates to iOS are coming this fall. Stay tuned and subscribe to Macworld for your Apple coverage.